And they thought that Hunter Biden's role at Burisma might be significant enough that it would come up during your confirmation. Is that correct?
Apparently so. I mean, there were hundreds of questions.
Well, hundreds of questions, but were there hundreds of companies? How many companies other than Burisma did the Obama-Biden State Department prepare you to give answers for? And if so, if there were others, which ones?
I just don't recall.
You don't recall that there were any other companies, is that correct?
I'm quite sure there probably were some companies, but I mean, you know, this is a while ago and I don't recall.
But you specifically recall Burisma?
Yes.
All right. Out of thousands of companies in the Ukraine, the only one that you recall the Obama-Biden State Department preparing you to answer questions about was the one where the vice president's son was on the board. Is that fair?
Yes.
You understood from Deputy Assistant Secretary George Kent's testimony, as it's been related to you, that he testified a few days ago. Do you understand that that arrangement, Hunter Biden's role on the Burisma board, caused him enough concern that, as he testified in his statement, that in February of 2015, I raised my concern that Hunter Biden's status as a board member could create the perception of a conflict of interest? And he went on to talk about the vice president's responsibilities over the Ukraine and or over Ukrainian policy as one of those factors. Do you recall that?
Yes.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
That it was a legitimate concern to raise?
I think that it could raise the appearance of a conflict of interest.
And